listening to Advice Line with Roy Masters. Call Roy at 1-800-866-8883.
Okay, now we go to Anthony. How do you say Anthony or Anthony? How do you say that?
Anthony.
Anthony, okay. How are you doing, Omar? How are you doing?
I'm doing good. And what you told Carlos, I was listening to, and that has a lot to do. I guess I have to practice on the same thing Carlos is, what you recommended Carlos to do.
Yeah, you have arthritis, which is rheumatoid arthritis, right?
This is correct.
Well, that is in young people, but you see, it's sort of somewhat natural for old people to get a little bit creaky, but some people become twisted like they're monsters, you know. And the reason for, I give you the reason, what I believe to be the reason, and I guarantee you it's dead on the money, is that when you're emotional, your body goes crazy. The programming gets affected, and let's leave it at that. But the effect of the programming is this: when it comes, a person can have 100,000 different symptoms from being upset about something. 100,000 at least, which is most of the things that are wrong with people, 90% at least. And with arthritis, I'm dead sure for this, that what happens is that the interchange of calcium between the blood and the bones becomes affected, and they get deposited in the wrong place. So your bones are always being renewed. I think you have a new skeleton, a new body every 7 or 8 years. See that? So this can be corrected if your attitude is pure. And it's not pure because you've got lots of irritations and frustrations, especially with your conditions, which are crippling you and keeping you from your destination, so you think. Actually, it's a wake-up call. Your arthritis is a very good thing for you. Everybody needs to be sick of something. And if suffering doesn't awaken you, nothing will. That's what suffering is for, is to awaken you. It's a good thing.
I'm just ashamed it's taken 13 years for me to wake up.
Well, never mind. I've been married 57 years to my wife, and she hasn't woken up yet, so she's still playing games. The thing is, I know a man who's listened to me for 45 years. He came up one morning to my Sunday morning talk. By the way, this one is called Letting Go of Your Bad Dad. Letting Go of Your Bad Dad is the one that's up there right now. It's a very good discussion. But he came, he was 85 years old. And he brought his relatives up to Sunday morning talk. And he said, finally, he saw the truth. But he'd supported me all these years, even though he hadn't found it. He loved listening to me, but somehow couldn't get it. And then one morning it just happened. So don't be embarrassed about 13 years. That's nothing. It's 13 years of suffering it took to bring you to this suffering. So because when doctors can't help you, they're going to give you relief that doesn't cure anything. You just live longer and you get worse.
Exactly.
When you get worse, you've got more medication, and it's just miserable. Go ahead.
I think I've come a long way in a few months dealing with my anger and resentment. And
a
friend of mine showed me your program. I've been listening. I finished one book, and I'm starting Be Still and Know. But I can't meditate past 5 minutes.
This is what you need to do. I'll show you a quickie way of meditating. Are you ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
Okay, close your eyes. Now, I'm only going to ask you to do a very simple thing. Look at your eyelids from the inside. And it's like the blinds are drawn, and you can see the inside of your eyelids. And it's sort of like, well, you actually can't look at your eyelids without being aware of your forehead. It's almost like you have a screen up there, and there's no picture on it. There's just a lot of little pixels moving around, like little lights moving around. You see that?
Yes.
Yeah, well, that's meditation. You're right there. Now, every now and then, since there's no thoughts there, you're above your thoughts. That's where you are. You're actually above them right there. if you can hold it. But all of a sudden, up through the mist, through the vortex, that the invisible veil that separates you from thought, your thoughts will come up and grab you and pull you down. Just return to that state. And to facilitate that, be aware of your right hand tingling, the first finger. So while you're looking through the forehead like that, your eyelids, and seeing that those little light show, transfer that to the tingling of your first finger. Are you doing that?
Yeah.
Okay, and then the next finger, and keep alternating the fingers and starting again with the thumb. And every time a thought comes up to grab you, pull you down, and you get lost in a daydream, just reset yourself, reboot yourself. Bingo. It may only last for a second or two when you do it on your own. That's all you need to do to meditate. Nothing. You don't have to ask for anything. Nothing. It'll all happen by itself. The good that's waiting for you there, mystically, mysteriously, will take over. Simple?
Yeah.
Open your eyes. How do you feel now? Do you feel any different? Just wondering.
Just a sense of calmness.
And can you feel your pain without being resentful?
You know, it's funny. When I opened my eyes, the pressure and the pain is subsided. And
we only did it for 1 minute.
And
see how beautiful and simple it is. There's no more to it than that. So it really isn't much to buy, is it? I don't have much to sell.
But one more thing, Roy.
Okay.
I've done the meditation, and I'm doing that. And, you know, I do resent my dad, my father, and I've forgiven him. I've said...
No, you haven't. No, you haven't. No, you haven't.
I know, and that's just... I've been trying, and I've been trying for months to forgive him, and...
No, you don't try. You just know you need to, and you don't. You know that your resentment is wrong. You're playing God two ways, and you're in danger when you think like this. I'll give you my own experience. A man says to me, "I have resented you for 10 years, Mr. Masters. Can you forgive me?" I said, "No. I don't need to." "What do you mean you don't need to?" "Well, I didn't resent you. I didn't judge you for resenting me, so therefore, if I don't judge you, I don't need to forgive you. See, because if I judge you, I'm guilty. When I'm guilty, I'm playing God. So now the other part of God kicks in. I feel guilty, but God can't be guilty, so it has to try to forgive that person and give him a pass. Well, maybe you're giving the wrong person a pass. And when you're giving somebody a pass, you make them worse. That's how the game works. So you really need to, in this meditative technique, God has already forgiven you for all that. You need to know that, because you cannot forgive. You can only be forgiven. You have to know that you've been forgiven, and in that state of mind, forgiveness will come into you like a thief of a night. Do you understand, Anthony?
Yes, I do.
All right, my friend. When you've been forgiven, then you can pay it forward. You can't do it. Only God forgives you for playing God. Judging, in other words. We'll be right back.